All right, two things with Evan Carradine here. One, you felt you should have sent photos yourself.
I didn't know you could do that. Right. I should have been taking pictures on my way here.
Right. Because you live in the canyons, right?
Yes.
And so branches.
Branches everywhere, garbage cans all down the middle of the road. But we made it. We were on time.
Okay. And here you are. And then before taking her seat here, ever complimented by our stage manager, Jim, on her camera consciousness.
You know. Well, I didn't want to walk across if you were reading or that camera's pointed, so I ducked.
You were too considerate.
Yeah, you know, I'm here for everyone.
You are.
Obviously, the last name gives you the clue. When was the first time you were on a set?
Three. Yeah, little. And I spent my whole all my childhood pictures that I drew were like from the back pages of scripts because we didn't have paper around the house. My dad would just give me a script and a piece of, you know, and a pencil, and that's where all my coloring was.
And so does this feel like, you know, where other people are like, oh, show business, it's so glamorous, it's all that.
Yeah, is it like, no, it's not old hat. It's always exciting.
Right,
I mean, I feel like walking on a film set is always exciting, and walking on a TV set is always exciting.
Lots of projects that you've involved with that have been very exciting. Let's talk about Handmaid's Tale.
It was a big night.
Right.
It was a fun night.
Why is it that this is just resonating award after award after award?
I mean, I think that the show is it's so well written. It's so well done. Colin, our DP, is a genius, and Lizzie Moss, I think, just is... She's incredible. I love watching her. I love watching the show. It's the only show I've ever been on where when I'm on set, I actively think of like how I can help Offred escape Gilead. I can't seem to separate like reality from fiction, but I don't know. It's just really, it struck a chord.
And when you mention Elizabeth Moss, because I think she is this extraordinary actress, and when you're... And you can see it right there, like when you're doing it, obviously.
It's like sometimes I'll forget to say my line because I'm so kind of transfixed by just watching her be Offred. And yeah, I'm really very invested in helping her escape in my mind. Oh. Ever Carradine is. Naomi Putnam is not.
Right. And then do you know what is going to happen with season two? Or?
I do.
Okay.
We're halfway through.
Oh, wow.
I go back in a couple weeks to shoot some more. They shut down just for all the award season stuff. But it's really good. I think that the first season did such an incredible job of sort of setting up Gilead and who all these people are and how this world works. And then the second season, they kind of get to run with it. And the stories are really exciting. And I don't want to reveal anything, but it's really good.
All right. Now, and you're in the pleasant circumstance where it's not just one cool job, it's a bunch.
I like two. Yeah. I like to have two at a time.
And has that always been the way, or do you find, this is what we're talking about almost every day, that now... Last 3 or 4 years, there's more opportunities to have 2 or 3 or 4 things going.
There really is, and I'm in the luck. I only like to do shows with red robes, apparently. and they're both on Hulu, and so I have the great circumstance of having one boss and two.
And you
two
get
jobs.
Free Hulu.
I do. That's a nice little perk.
Because Netflix seems very selective. Some of the Netflix stars get free Netflix and some don't.
Oh, no. Did I just spill the beans? I get free Hulu. Oh,
and is it regular Hulu or that Hulu Plus?
Well, you know, it's regular Hulu.
Right.
But now that Runaways just got a second season, maybe they'll up it to the one without the commercials. We'll see.
Talk to us about Runaways. You play a mom?
I play a mom. I play Janet Stein. And tonight's our finale. Or today. I mean, I guess you can watch it whenever you want to watch it. But there we are. There's a red robe.
Boy, you red is your thing.
I do. I like a red robe.
All right. Without revealing any season finale spoilers, what can you tell us?
Episode 9 ended with sort of a standoff with the parents and the pride. And you will get to see... how that maybe works itself out or doesn't.
All things are explained. The season finale of Marvel's Runaways airs tonight on Hulu, or you can watch it now, I suppose.
Yeah, and we'll also be live tweeting tonight at 6 p.m.
Oh, have you practiced? Are you ready?
No, I think I have to do it on my computer. I don't think I can tweet that fast. But yes, the whole cast will be live tweeting starting at 6 p.m.
Ever, nice to see you.
Thank you so much. Nice to see you guys.
Take care.